Hi, my name is Sébastien Lavoie, and welcome to this introduction to Hyle. Hyle is a new tool that allows you to automate tasks in After Effects quickly and easily. By using a simple and understandable text syntax, you will be able to generate and affect content in an efficient and reusable way. Here's an example of what Hyle can do from a simple text file. Now, if we hit play, a lot of things have been generated. My complete folder structure has been created and organized. A couple of files have been imported and stored in their respective folders. All of my layers have been logically organized with their own effects, keyframes, expressions, mats, and parents. Now, if we take a brief look at the file, we'll see that everything it contains is a readable description of what is in the resulting file. We have our files listed here, our folder structure, the main composition with the layers it contains, some expression. Everything is in there. Now, let's say I'd like to add some Gaussian blur on that last layer. I'd be able to do that with just a few keystrokes. Let's now start from the beginning to learn how Hyle works. Hyle is a script in which you can either paste text or upload a text file. From the text provided in the uploaded file or in the text area, Hyle will parse it and then generate or modify content accordingly. This can be really useful for creating a template project, keeping effects presets in a readable form, applying expressions, generating a lot of text layers, or any other thing you had to repeatedly create or modify from the After Effects interface and wished there was a better way. Now, I'll jump to my text editor, where I have already written a basic Hyle list. I will be using an external text editor to show you code example, since After Effects Text Area does not display code very well. I'd advise you to use a text area for pasting more than writing, since the text area doesn't support tabs, which are really important in our syntax. But if you really want to use it, you can use spaces instead of tabs, and it will work just as well. Now, without knowing much about Hyle's syntax, you will probably be able to tell that this list will generate a basic composition with the name of demonstration with some basic settings. Now I'll copy all of this and I will paste it inside of my direct input text area. Now I'll hit submit. And as you can see, my demonstration composition was created. And if I hit command K, I will see that my composition has the good name and all the settings that were defined. Now, we will probably want to add some layers inside of this composition. So I will go back to my text editor. I will create a new file in which I will write layers colon line break tab. I will add an hyphen and then a space. And I will write type colon solid, then a line break again, and another tab, and then color FF8000, which is the Xcode for a bright orange. You can find Xcode of every color in any color panel of every Adobe software. It's always made out of 6 characters ranging from 0 to F. So you just pick your color, copy this, and then paste it. I will also create another layer on top of my solid layer. I will make this a text layer by writing type colon text and then writing text and maybe like demonstration time. Now what have I done here? The layers property here states that we will be defining layers, and the hyphen states that we are defining one of the many layers. Everything that is indented deeper than my hyphen means that we are defining various properties of my current layer. There are a lot of properties that you can use. You can find them all on the website at hyle.io/docs. Again, I will copy this, paste it in my direct input text area, submit, and here we go. Our two layers were generated. Hyle does not only generate, but also modifies content. So if I want to modify the transform properties of my text layer and maybe scale it because it's a little small, I will write transform, then scale, and I will open the brackets since there are two values, the X scale and the Y scale, and I will write 300 and 300. And of course we can also animate using Hyle. So we'll animate the rotation. Now let's write rotation. and I will write keyframes and then add an hyphen since we want many keyframes, and time 0, and we'll want the value, let's say maybe -360, and at 2 seconds we'll want the value of 0. So again, I will copy this, I'll go back to After Effects, I will paste this inside of my direct input text area, and I need to select the layer that I want to be affected. All the layers that are selected will be affected. Since we don't want our background to be affected, I will only select my text layer. Now I'll hit submit, and as you can see, it has been scaled to 300, and if I open my keyframes, you can see that it is -1 turn, and if we press play, it'll spin around. This is beautiful. Of course, Hyle can also create effects. So I will write effects, and we will create a 4-color gradient. So let's type 4, there's a dash, color, and gradient. Something that is important to keep in mind is that every value or property that you are getting from After Effects, such as effects names or properties names, don't worry about the capitalization. Just keep it lowercase and Hyle will handle the rest. Now we'll write properties to state that what will be written next are properties of the current effect. And I will write color 1. What I will write inside of my properties will be what will appear when I use the effect. So I could use the 0.1 and then give it a value. I could use blend, jitter, opacity, whatever. I can affect all the properties that are named here, as long as I keep the name in lowercase. So I've written color 1. I will write an X code that I will want. So let's get a red, and I will also type color 2 with green, and I will duplicate that line, and we will make it a big blue, and for color 4 we'll make this white. So let's copy all of this, go back inside of After Effects, and again I will paste it inside of my direct input text area, and with my solid layer selected I will press submit, and there you go. I could also have added many effects at the same time. So if, for example, I'd want to add the glow effect, I'd just type another hyphen, type glow. And by the way, you can always press Ctrl Z to undo what Hyle has done. So I will paste this here, submit, and then I have this not so beautiful effect created by my 4-color gradient and my glow effect. Now, before we end this, let's create a folder structure in which we'll put this composition. Now, instead of going inside of my text editor, I will go on GitHub, where I have this Hyle list that I often use to kickstart my new projects. And this is what makes Hyle really interesting. You can save it as text anywhere you want. Instead of copy-pasting it inside of my direct input as I've done since the beginning, I will save this file as a standalone file on my desktop as starter.hyle. Of course, the Hyle extension is not mandatory. .txt would do just as fine, but I prefer having the Hyle extension so the files are easier to identify. So I'll save it. Now we'll go back inside of After Effects, and I will use the Upload a File button. I will select the file, and as you can see, the folders have been created. If I toggle them open, you can see that all my structure has been created easily. So now I can just take my composition and drag it inside of my scenes folder and just close these folders. Of course, these were just some really basic examples of how you can use Hyle, but it's really just the tip of the iceberg. There will be other videos in which we will dig deeper and use some more advanced features. Make sure to check the full documentation on the website. It goes over everything there is to know to get you started, the advanced tricks, and a list of all the available properties. Thanks for watching this tutorial, and I hope you will enjoy using Hyle.